All right.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today here in the sight of God, in the presence of this company, to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is honorable estate instituted of God, blessed by the Lord Jesus Christ and declared by St. Paul to be honorable among all men and women. It is not therefore to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, soberly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Let us therefore, under the seriousness of this act, invoke the divine presence upon this occasion. Almighty and gracious God, our Heavenly Father, granted blessings upon these two children, look in favor upon them as they come together in love and hope. Be thou the honored guest at their wedding and help them to speak their vows in honestly and truth. Teach them how to live in this world according to thy morals, laws, and they may find happiness and unfoldness together. Teach them how to live in kindness, in patience, and in love, always willing to forgive, the wellspring of true happiness. And now, Father, let us union be of our divine providence, and may they be eternally joined together as they abide under the canopy of the Holy Spirit forever. Amen.
Amen.
To you who are assembled here in the presence of God, hear these words of the Holy Scripture taken from 1 Corinthians. And now I will show you the most excellent way. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. There are three pillars on which marriage may be built: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. beginning of time when the human family was young and without the structure of formal garments. The great seal and state were fixed with rings worn by monarchs, and its stamp was the sole sign of its authority. A simple band of gold was exchanged between monarchs as a sign of their friendship. Today, this conventional ring has gained a far deeper meaning. It has become a symbol of the deepest, dearest meaning of a man's love for a woman and a woman's love for a man. What token do you give as a symbol of love for Crystal Nicole Royster? This wedding ring is a complete circle without beginning or end. It is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts in trust and endless love. Crystal Nicole Royster, when you receive this ring from Alan Michael Earl as a token of his affection, sincerity, and fidelity toward you, and when you wear it as a symbol of your own affection, sincerity, and fidelity toward him, to the groom, you will now place the ring
they're right there.
You will now place this ring on her finger on the left hand of the bride and repeat after me. You will place the ring on her third finger of the left hand of your bride and repeat after me.
This ring,
I give thee, as a token of my abiding love, and with all my earthly goods, I endow. With this ring, I do wed in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Crystal Nicole Royster, what token do you give the symbol of love to Alan Michael Earl? You will now place the ring on the third finger of his left hand of your husband to repeat after me. There you go. Yeah. And repeat after me. This ring I give thee as a token of my abiding love, and with all my earthly goods I endow. With this ring I be with in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Before we go any further, well, Al has something he wants to say. Hey, George, man, George.
No, you can't have the mic.
been in your life for a year and a half or so, probably a little more than that. And I love your mom with all my heart. And I wanted to get your permission and place this ring on your finger and ask you if it's okay that I marry your mom. Can I marry your mom and be your dad? Can I be your dad and marry your mom?
No, give me, yeah, give me this finger right here.
Thank you.
That was so cute.
I think that's so sweet.
It is.
Okay, Jordan, can you make them come close as a kid? Okay. Give them that pillow with the box right now. Now you grab her right now. I'm going to say this before we go, Father. Through all the trials and the tribulations that you had to endure up to this point, after this, it was well worth it. Because anytime you come together in God's eyesight, the Bible says, listen to the Bible. The Bible says that it's good for a man to have a wife. The Bible says a man that findeth a wife findeth a good thing. And he didn't leave it, and he said that he obtained favor. I'd rather have favor than money any day. Because with favor in God's eyes, we'll bring the money. It'll bring you the favor. So long as y'all know within y'all heart, this is honorable in God's eyesight. Don't listen to what nobody says. All y'all have to do is depend on each other. As long as you put God in the midst of it, everything is going to be all right. Now, if I stand here and tell you that everything is going to be peaches, then I'll be lying to you. But together, you can make it. Y'all understand? Watch and see what the Lord going to do for you. Because you've been battling. Ever since you see y'all, ever since y'all got together, say y'all were gonna do this, y'all been fighting. It's been a spiritual fight. But the enemy will not win today. Because what God puts together, no man can take it apart. For as much as Alan Michael Erwick and Crystal Nicole Royster have consented together to enter the holy ring of marriage for God and these witnesses, I have given and received a ring and a token and a pledge of their love to the faith in each other, and having declared the same by joining of their right hand, I declare by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel that you are husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the law of the state, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Repeat after me, both of y'all. Entreat me not to leave thee or to return from following after thee. For whether thou goest, I will go. And where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God. Where thou diest, will I die. And there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also. If all but death part thee, and me. Our gracious, beloved Father, thou who have made the entire family of earth and heaven be, thou pleased to bless and seal the vows that these thy servant, Michael, these thy servant, Alan Michael Irving, and Crystal Nicole Royster have taken with thine approval. Would thou grant this husband and wife all spiritual grace and the willingness to keep the vow and covenant between them made. Be their defense against all temptation, but be their bulwark in the time of indifferences and amidst adversities. O Heavenly Father, endow them with the strength and the spirit to bear whatsoever of life's burdens. May they live for each other in peace, and may their home be placed of thy abiding rest through Jesus Christ, our Lord. When symbolizing the church, the Lord's Prayer may be sung as a solo. Okay, listen. We're going to ask that you will go to the unity calendar. Like he getting restless. Grab hands again. I'm gonna say it one more time. By the power of this is in you, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Come on in. May we bow. Our gracious Father God, we just thank you for what you have done on today, God. God, and we ask that you be with these young people, God, as they grow in you together, God. For we bind the enemy on every hand. God, give them the wisdom and the knowledge that they will be able to come together when things don't seem right, God, and work it out. With you being in the midst of them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Through these times.
So where's the horse and carriage?
It's at 7:30.
Okay.
And it's 6:45.